Okay, so this tutorial is designed to help you learn how to create a graph using Microsoft Excel. This is more or less going to take you to the same steps listed in exercise 2 that follow question 1. Now, I understand that some students will not have access, at least on their personal computers, to Microsoft Excel, but you have access to Excel as a student of Cal State Northridge, both in computer labs on campus, and it is also downloadable because you are enrolled as a student. Now, I'm going to use the latest version, which is version 15. It looks the most like the rest of the versions out there, so I figured it's the best universal type to use for this tutorial. Now, the options may differ very slightly depending on which version you're using, but nevertheless, I found a video tutorial is always very helpful in helping students to understand how to learn a new skill. So the first thing you want to do is download the Air Layer Data XLSX file. Now I'm just going to go to my download folder. I know I am using a Mac, but the other reason I'm using version 15 for this tutorial is because it looks the same regardless of whether you're on PC or Mac. And I'm going to open this file now with Microsoft Excel app. I'm just going to minimize things I don't need here to get them out of the way. Okay. So question 1 asks you to create a graph showing the average temperature of the atmosphere versus the altitude in kilometers. That's going to be columns A and B. So go ahead, and what I just did is I left clicked, held, and dragged until I selected both columns A and B. And then let go, and basically you have a multi-column select. Because what we're doing now is we're saying, okay, Microsoft Excel, you are going to create a graph using these two columns. So the next thing we need to do is to tell it, okay, create a graph. So we're going to go to the Insert tab. So click Insert, and if you move over to the right, you'll notice there's several different chart icons. The one we want is the scatter chart. So click the down arrow, and then we're going to use the scatter chart with the straight lines and markers. So click on that option. And you'll notice that right away we have a profile that is starting to resemble what the atmospheric temperature profile actually looks like. Now we have a couple other things that we need to do to clean this chart area up before we can call it done and ready to submit. The first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to need to get this vertical axis out of the way. By default, it is going to be lined up at 0, 0. You all remember from high school geometry, 0, 0, it's called the point of origin. That is where the x-axis and the y-axis meet, but in computers, we don't have to let it be that way. So click on the horizontal axis, make sure it's highlighted with the box you see, or in some similar manner, right click, and then select the format axis option. Now, some of you, depending on your version of Excel, might get a box that pops up right in front of the graph. That's basically what you see here. The new version just places it as a pane on the right side. So go down to where you see vertical axis crosses. We're going to change that from automatic to axis value. And we're going to replace 0 with negative 100. And then hit enter. And notice that the vertical axis has now been shifted to the left side. Okay, so we can go ahead and close out the options menu. Now, we're going to need to identify our axes. So what we're going to do is with the graph still selected, we need that to be selected so we can get these options right here in the top left of the menu. Click on Quick Layout. And then click on the very top left option. This gives us the option to add titles to our axes and our graph. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is we want to try to somehow get this vertical axis title out of the way, or the label that is, out of the way of the actual graphs. There we go. Just drag the chart area all the way to the right. What this does is it opens up space here in the left, and now we can highlight our axis title and drag it to the left. Sometimes it takes a little bit of practice to get used to this. Don't expect this to be perfect right away. It gets frustrating It still frustrates me, and I've been doing this for a long time. So we're going to change axis title, the boring generic axis title. In this case, the vertical axis is going to be altitude. And we're going to want to put in parentheses km to indicate that it is in kilometers. We're going to do the same thing to the axis title on the horizontal axis. And we're going to change that to temperature. In this case, just or uppercase C. Don't worry about the symbol. It's not a big deal. And for the title, you can make it, it doesn't have to be exactly this, but you can make it something similar, Earth's atmosphere. You could even make it something as boring and simple as, you know, altitude versus temperature. Doesn't matter. Okay, so we're almost there. We just have a couple more things we need to do. And you'll notice that one of the steps asks you, but the next step basically asks you to identify each layer in the atmosphere. Now, you'll realize by studying or just taking a glance and looking over these numbers here, particularly the temperature, that certain trends pop up. In particular, we have two values of negative 58. We have two values of 0 and two values of negative 90. These are locations of what we call the pauses. The pauses like the tropopause, the stratopause, and the mesopause. They are the indicators of where the atmosphere is beginning to transition to another layer. So temperature is how we define atmospheric layers. Notice how this kind of zigzags back and forth. First thing we need to do is to add lines to delineate or to mark where the layers are. So to do this, we're going to go to the insert menu once again. Make sure your graph is selected. Then we're going to move all the way over to shapes. And then once you have shapes and you click the down arrow, click on the line symbol. It should be towards the top left. It's one of the more common shapes used. Now what we're going to do is we're going to draw the lines basically at the bottom of each pause. That's where the layers are. That's where the markers are, if you will. So what we're going to do is, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start on the left axis, and you should see crosshairs. And when you're ready to start your line, left click once, also hold shift at the same time. What this does is it allows you to make a perfectly straight line. The shift key is the key to making it straight. Now notice that my line is just a bit below where it should be. You can use your arrow keys to shift it up to where it should be, right there. That's perfect. Now, my recommendation is we're going to want to change the coloring and the options a bit. So right-click on the line with it selected, then select Format Shape. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the color black. And then I'm also going to make my line dashed. I'm just going to stay with that. You can do whatever you like. You can format it any way you like. I just recommend, highly recommend, you making your line look different or stand out from the actual curve on the graph. Now, to make this easy, we're not going to draw another line. We're going to click once just to make sure that our line is selected. Then click Control C or Command C, depending on your PC or Mac. And then click Control V or Command V, and what that does is another line pops up. So you've just copied and pasted the line in this exact same formatting, place its clone, if you will, in its proper location, and do it once more to create a third line. Three is all you need. So once you have these three lines placed at the bottom of the three pauses, then you're done with this step. And you were left with really with only one more required step, and that is identifying the different pauses and layers by adding text. So what we're going to do now is with the main chart area selected, so click basically in the white space here on the chart, then go up to Insert, click on Shapes once again, but this time click on the text option. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm first going to click right down here in the troposphere where we live. And you're going to get a huge box. We can deal with that later. Just type in the text for right now, troposphere. So now I can resize it. I can move it out of the way. In fact, I'm not going to worry about changing the font right now. It's not a big deal. So that's the troposphere, right? Control, copy, control, paste. So control C, control V once again, just like we did with our lines. And then you have your stratosphere. You do it again, and you have your mesosphere. And finally, our thermosphere. So what I just did was I copied the troposphere box and then pasted it, and it just kind of places a copy or a clone in space, and I just drag that clone to where it should be, and then I'm done. So now I've labeled my layers. In fact, you don't even need to label the pauses. Unnecessary. The last thing you could do if you'd like, and this is not required, is you can play with this a little bit to add some color. You know, for instance, let's say you want to select the chart area. You want to make it look like sky. So you select the chart area, right click, select format plot area. So you could play with these a little bit, perfect them. So I'm going to select a gradient fill. I mean, when you do that, you can actually play with these to the point where it looks like you kind of have a sky. So notice that it gets a little wider as you go up, simulates the sky. If you do something like this, you may want to click on the line, which in this case will automatically bring up the formatting options for the line. And you can change the line color, which is something I'd recommend if you make your sky blue. I'm going to move this legend out of the way. And these are just examples of other things you can do to personalize your graph if you'd wish. You don't have to do this. This is not a requirement, but it is good to know that these different options do exist, because it is good to know how to graph in Excel, because you're probably going to end up doing it in other courses, perhaps in whatever career you choose. So this is a good time to practice or learn this skill. Okay, so once you're done with your graph, let's just assume this is done. You're going to basically want to export this as a picture. To do that, click on the chart area, the white space here. Right click it once again, and you should see some option on this right click menu, also called the context menu, that says save as picture. So with this selected, I can go to my downloads. I could place it in my downloads folder, and I can call this temp, and I'm going to use underscore altitude. You can call it whatever you want. Just make sure you know what it's called. Any of these formats should be okay, particularly JPEG, PNG, or GIF. PNG and JPEG probably the two most preferable as far as the picture format. Click save, and if you check your downloads folder, you'll now have a photo. Basically is what that is. It's a picture. And you can open it up in your operating system's photo viewer to verify that. And it's this item that you're going to submit on Moodle using the first of two submission links. So you'll have the submit temperature versus altitude graph. Now, my view looks different because I have the master view, which doesn't have the submission option. But this is where you will submit it. You will see a submission option. I'm sure you've all used Moodle before. It's the same process at this point. Okay? Now, you're going to be asked later on in this assignment to create just one more graph. Just one more. And it's going to be air pressure and altitude this time. The only difference in creating that graph is you're going to use column C and D, but everything else is identical. Okay, I hope this video helped you out. Please feel free to watch it over and over again, and let your instructor know if you have any questions. Good luck.